Hello, in this video I'll introduce you to Coverity Test Advisor, a part of the Coverity development testing platform that helps reduce the risk of costly and brand damaging quality issues and software failures downstream. Everybody agrees that testing software is important. Unfortunately, it's not always obvious how to implement testing so that it is efficient and effective. It's especially hard to understand effectiveness without detailed knowledge of the code, which often means tedious manual effort. Measuring code coverage is probably the most common metric, but it's rarely enough by itself. One big problem is that there's no universal standard for how much coverage is enough. That number is highly application specific. In practice, coverage reports are interesting but flawed. There's no easy way to ascertain testing effectiveness or efficiency. Developers may not spend enough time writing tests, leaving the test suite ineffective, or they spend too much time writing tests that don't appreciably improve the quality of the project. Moreover, unnecessary tests can extend the testing cycle, exacerbating efficiency problems. To remedy this situation, developers need a way to target the test cases that will have the most impact and to prioritize test runs to fail quickly when there are problems. Coverity Test Advisor addresses these problems, enabling you to improve the efficiency of developing and running tests and to easily assess testing effectiveness. It helps you ensure that 100% of your high-risk code is tested in development, shortening the QA and rework cycle for faster time to market. You accomplish this through a simple four-step process. 1. Define your high-risk criteria, from which we can infer which code needs to be tested. 2. Analyze your code and tests, using patent-pending techniques with a deep understanding of the code. 3. Remediate identified issues. 4. Govern and enforce your testing policies. You define your high-risk criteria in high-level terms. For example, you may decide that you want all new or modified code and anything impacted by such code to have 100% test coverage by line. The key to Test Advisor's success is its ability to understand the code in great detail. This enables you to define exactly what is important to you. For example, maybe you don't want to worry about testing error cases, debugging code, certain exception handling code, or code that's never executed in production. Next, analyze the code in the context of your testing policy to identify actionable violations. It starts with the Coverity Static Analysis Verification Engine, or SAVE. SAVE utilizes patent-pending techniques from test data correlation to change impact analysis. SAVE communicates with other parts of the platform to ensure it understands when and what has changed in the code, and what parts of the code are covered by tests. It correlates that data with its deep understanding of the code to identify things like how code changes affect other areas of code. It uses this detailed information to determine any violations. Test Advisor then surfaces untested code violations alongside quality and security defects in a standard process for efficient management to closure. This gives you confidence that development testing time is spent wisely and more critical defects are found in development. The platform fits into your SDLC, meaning that information flows to other tools like your bug tracking or ALM system to ensure effective communication with the rest of the team. Everybody benefits from the most accurate, scalable, developer-friendly platform with the lowest false positive rate in the industry. Now that you can easily measure testing effectiveness, and your developers and testers understand exactly what to work on, you can create a stage gate ensuring that code doesn't progress to later stages until it is adequately tested. By gaining visibility into testing deficiencies, you're able to hold developers accountable for testing. This is what you might see when you log into the Coverity Connect web interface. You have shortcuts along the left which help you quickly start addressing the important issues. Maybe you want to see all new issues or all of your work items. Both are a single click away. There are obviously a lot of other choices, and you can customize these views to support your daily tasks. Each of those links changes the list of issues in the top center of the page. That list contains all the issues in Coverity Connect which match the selected filter, not just those surfaced by Test Advisor. You can see that I have a few different types of issues in my list. This is a great time saver for developers, since they can view and prioritize all their issues in one place and get a global view. Those test violations are the violations identified by Test Advisor. By creating work items assigned to developers, Test Advisor ensures that users are writing the test cases that you care about, not wasting time writing tests that are not important and that inflate your testing runtimes. Note that each of the issues is associated with an impact category, high, medium, or low. This gives developers more information about which issues to address first, since some issues will be more important to you than others. Let me open one to show you how it works. The first thing you may notice is the annotation in the source code that describes what is wrong. This annotation provides a lot of useful information. Which rule triggered the violation, which function is affected, how many additional lines need to be tested, and the required coverage. This information helps you quickly understand what needs to be done. You'll also notice the vertical bars between the source and the line numbers. The red dotted bars indicate the specific lines that are missing test coverage. The more bars you see for a line, the younger that line of code is. Also note the gray bars, which indicate code that was excluded by the testing policy. These exclusions enable Test Advisor to enforce your testing policy without burying developers under a mountain of violations. In this case, it looks like we added some new code around line 879. We use an improve it as you touch it policy, meaning that legacy uncovered code is okay, but anytime a developer changes legacy code, they should ensure it is also tested. This ensures that new code is well tested, and the backlog of legacy untested code gets smaller over time as needed. The new code itself does not need to be tested based on the policy, but there is some legacy untested code on line 884 that does need to be tested. When configured in the testing policy, TestAdvisor can even follow the impact of this change up the call graph, identifying violations and legacy functions that are impacted by calls to this function. Since this is legacy code that hasn't been touched in a while, developers may not be familiar with which existing tests cover it. This is another area where TestAdvisor's detailed knowledge of your code and tests can help. Just hover over an adjacent coverage bar to see which test cases already visit that line. You may want to create a new test based on one of those cases, or extend an existing case to cover this line. That's more time and effort saved. To help you understand the impact of each violation, you can see which other branches and projects are affected by this same issue. That way, you can easily tell if you need to add the same new test in multiple places. The triage pane is where the developer remediates the violation. This violation was automatically assigned to me, ensuring that no time is wasted on redundant investigation. I've indicated that it needs a fix, and these settings are automatically shared with the rest of the team. The settings are remembered in subsequent analyses, so you don't need to waste time sifting through the same violation report with every testing run. Once a new test is created to cover this code, we'll even automatically recognize that it has been fixed. TestAdvisor and Coverity Connect are designed to simplify things for the developer. You don't need to guess about code paths or values, or jump around to different functions, files, or windows while investigating issues. Targeted testing violations are injected directly into your workflow, where they can be addressed quickly and efficiently. You get more bang for your testing buck because you know that your test cases are addressing high-risk code. With Coverity Policy Manager, you can take it a step further to easily visualize compliance to the testing policy across the enterprise. You no longer need to worry about how much coverage is required for each project or component because those details are hidden in the individual testing rules. At this level, you can easily see which components are meeting their goals and which ones need to improve testing. For more information about Policy Manager, please view our Policy Manager video on this site. Thank you for taking the time to learn more about Coverity Test Advisor. For more information about the Coverity development testing platform, please visit coverity.com, send us a message, or request a trial.